And then, you know, I find myself in like a paradox, you know, like throughout the years, because it's like, you would think like for anybody that, you know, perceive my journey, you know, and the substance of my character, you know, all these years and stuff, then it's evident, you know, not only in, had it been just the miracles, you know, God had done in the sight of many, you know, throughout the years, or, you know, if it's just for the substance of my speeches, you know, like I speak and my art, my poetry, or my articles or whatever, you know, if it wasn't for all that, then that should be a clear indicator of what my character is, you know, about like who I am as a man, you know, and then it shows that, you know, common sense would tell a person that okay, if you follow God, then, you know, you're going to do things synonymous with him. So therefore, the things that's not synonymous with him is not of him, you know, and it's not from him of his vessel. You know, common sense would say that, you know, so evil that's not, you know, evil that manifests in the world, God is not responsible for it. Neither is his vessels. You know, it's that simple. So it's somebody or something else that, you know what I mean? And it's that simple. And that something else is the devil, you know? And then the paradox come in because with knowing, you know, with that knowledge and that understanding and the discernment for those who possess an ear or possess an eye that they may see and hear, you know, and understand, you know, the information that they're being, you know, is being, you know, given to them. So anyone who did perceive and understand, you know, so the paradox part come in when as knowing, you know, of me pursuing on the paths of righteousness, the Bible says he who departs evil make himself a prey. And that is capitalized on by the Antichrist satanic influences that, you know, infatuated with mammon and sin. You know, those are the enemies of God, eternal enemies, because they're Antichrist and they're going to continue to persecute his Holy Spirit, which is the one unforgivable sin. They do it without even trying. You know, they do it. Now they realize what they've been doing. So now they can't stop it because they built so much. They built whole legacies and whole, they built a lot of stuff on, you know, the persecution of the Holy Spirit, you know, and, you know, through and destruction of God's vessels. So that became, you know, that's their, you know, I mean, that's the enemies of God, you know, for what he's done. So it's like knowing that those, you know, whoever responsible for that, they take that knowledge and they use it as beast. You know, they use it evilly, you know, to perpetuate my suffering wrongfully. You know what I'm saying? So it's like, well, they understand that the paradox is it put me in a position where I'm going to stay on the righteous path. I'm going to stay with God. I ain't compromising the word. But that also makes me a prey too, because that's giving them, that's making them feel as though it's fine to perpetuate my suffering. So there's nothing, the work against the evil, the Bible says the work against the evil is not expedient. Therefore, it's in the hearts of men to continue in that evil. And that's what it is. Like, it's like, when somebody see that you follow God and you a sheep, then it's like, well, his legacy, you know, well, my legacy being as influential as it has been through the years, it's changed a lot of lives in a good way. You know, it's spoke a lot of truth, you know, showed a lot of light, you know, and glorified God a lot. Everything that's of Satan and Antichrist resolve is automatically going to oppose that. And that's what has happened. You know, that's what happens. And so they naturally, the enemies of God, you know, that's God's eternal enemies, those individuals that's opposing my legacy and stuff, you know, so they, you know, they the eternal enemies of God. So when they see that you're a sheep and it's confirmed that you're a sheep, then that's going to confirm that they can freely do whatever evil against you as they please. You know, and that's, it's been a pattern that's been happening throughout the years. You know, and my only interest has been my legacy. You know, my ability to exist as an artist, and, you know, as an influence, you know, as who I am, you know, in society, who I really am, not the result of some type of slander or whatever was hinged upon my mere survival, you know, as not just a influence, but as a person, not just an entity or a brand, you know, but as an individual, things that were taken from me, you know, I didn't even have a chance to fight for it. You know, like things were taken from me and swindled from me without my consent or awareness of it intentionally, you know, due to me. It's like throwing a toddler in a boxing match, you know, with a full grown person, like, you know what I mean? Or like a real fight. Like, that's how it was. I mean, I was subjected to this heavy stuff that, you know, I was nowhere near, you know, prepared to fight, you know. And then regardless of who was doing it, they knew that, you know, but continued in that evil anyway, obsessively. So it's like, well, until the point of my death and destruction and demise. So my legacy outlived me, but you know, it's not to the extent that, you know, God made it, you know, God made the bad into good, you know, for the saving of many, like the words say, you know, but it didn't go as way as smoothly as it could have went. But I'm strangely kind of thankful, because I know in my lifetime, I did like a whole lot of good. Like, you know, I'm not the kind of person that bragging up, but I feel like I'm comfortable and I can rest in peace knowing that, you know, my contribution, you know, I just wanted to glorify God for one. That's my main goal, you know, and God could do fit as he see, you know, he could do as he see fit with my literary, because I do it for him. You know, it was when I first started, you know, I was finding myself and finding, you know, my niche and finding my pretty much my calling. And then it didn't take long, you know, before I started, that it just came out. And from there, your passion and your purpose and your talent, all that is intertwined. You know, all that is intertwined. And then, you know, God is in it. So, I mean, pretty much at this point now, you know, this far in time, everything is really self-evident at this point, you know. And so, I mean, the attacks and the paradox that I find myself in is I still being attacked, you know, the same. Like, it's a constant, continual sabotaging, because the interest of, you know, just my mere survival as a person is a bother to whatever, you know, wrongfully and falsely, you know, try to swindle me out of my legacy, life, love, you know, livelihood, every part of every facet of my life, mercilessly, you know, like a beast, like, you know. And that's how it's been, like, you know, to the utter destroyer and detriment of any influence I could have for God, with the Lord as my witness. And in these things is my testimony and witness of Jesus made manifest, you know, for the things which have happened and transpired has ultimately glorified God in showing that his presence is still continual and is near to those who are, you know, in need of help. And, you know, God is a refuge to those who fear him and believe in him. And that's the main thing that I wanted my legacy to show, you know, show God's presence, you know, because if it's like, if he did it for me, then he could do it for you. You know, I mean, that's not popular, you know, it's not popular in whatever's Antichrist ranks. You know, because off muscle is not going to be, you know, the things of God are not honored to what hates God, you know. So, and that was the thing, you know what I mean? So, I mean, it's a paradox I find myself in, but it's balance that you got to find. I mean, until God ready for me, I mean, you know, I want to just continue to show light on him through scripture. And then from the things I learned in my journey in the earth, you know, in my time, yo. So, I mean, it's fine with me. You know, this is what my life has been. It's been work unto God, not myself. So, if we die or live, we die to do so unto God and not ourselves. So, I mean, in that I find contentment and solace in knowing that this is my heart. Earned, you know, like, this is hard, the product of my hard work, you know, my legacy collectively, things, you know, I work hard for. And then, you know, having each invisible facet still being sabotaged by same Antichrist, demonic influence beings, whatever, you know, in the interest that I can no longer extend no further for God, by, you know, amplifying my success at certain times in proportion to what actual success I actually do receive. So it's like, some, you know, it's like that perspective of success is being manipulated by those that's wanting my downfall. You know what I'm saying? Those that don't want that success or don't want to see God glorified, knowing, you know, automatically that's what I'm going to do. And that's what I've been doing, you know. Yeah, but I mean, on my level of talent, it ain't really, you know what I mean? It's, you know, I haven't sold my soul to Satan, you know, so still under attack by that. So, that perspective of success is being manipulated for my life. Like, the perspective of my success is being manipulated by entities of influence that's 100% hands off it, you know. In reality, hands off it, you know. Like, they have no part in it, you know what I'm saying? But it's being manipulated by them to other people, you know, anonymously sometimes and quote-unquote inadvertently sometimes, you know, and it misportrays. It's like being used as a weapon. Perspective and, you know, ignorance and things will be used as weapons, you know, like to control how much God grows or be glorified. You know, that's what's happening. So if my influence, you know, is being like the perspective or perception of my success is being, you know, manipulated like that, then when I really, you know, it's manipulated during the times when I really have actual success in life to be more, you know what I'm saying? I mean, God made me huge, you know what I'm saying? He elevated me. I'm aware of that, you know, that's not going nowhere, you know what I mean? And just, I mean, your guys, the Bible says a man's gift will make room for him, you know what I'm saying, to bring him before great men. I mean, that's just the truth. This is something that I can do freely that others can't do like I can, you know, because God gave it to me, you know, so that's not ever going to change or go anywhere, you know. I mean, as far as what's already been created, that's just reality, you know, but those things, like the perspective of success be manipulated to be, and it's amplified sometimes during the moments, time sensitive. Now, mind you, you know, time sensitive during the key moments when actual success is attained in my life, then that perspective of success is over amplified in order to sabotage the actual success that I attain. So, you know, I'm being terrorized, you know, like brutally, you know what I'm saying, in spite of all forms of everything. Like, something is like, it's rogue, you know, it's like it's really like out of this world, and they're doing that on purpose. These satanic cults, you know, of influence that's conflicting interest with my talent, you know, not wanting me, you know, to be esteemed properly because of falsehoods that they had that was already promulgated or in rotation about me without my knowledge, like things I have no control over, you know. That's not my problem, you know. I can't control somebody slander me, you know, and I didn't know about it. You know, all I'm responsible for is being who I know I am, you know, and being myself and doing what I already was doing, regardless before they was or was not, you know, slandering me or saying all this. So it's like that perspective will be manipulated to sabotage my life further. So some wonder why, you know, you still be on the terrorism. That's domestic terrorism. And it's not just, you know, like, it's a situation that expands, you know, and encompasses every part of a person's life, you know. And I feel like, you know, the individual, what's responsible is not necessarily the commonplace as it is the satanic rulers and, you know, and wicked, you know, the wicked princes and kings and, you know, others and stuff, you know, that hates God, you know, that hates God, and that fruit show, you know, a person's fruit speaks for a show, the tree. I mean, that's how you know what kind of tree it is, by the fruit. That's how you know what kind of tree. And so, you know, I'm still under attack in these ways by these influences that they sabotage my life in these ways, you know. I'm still, and it's like there's nothing in the world that can stop them, or no one, rather, I put it like that, no one, you know. So that's why I promote the perspective that those who love God and they understand my righteous cause, and they, and those with a pure heart, I tell them, you know, fret not, you know what I'm saying, don't pity, you know, don't pity me or don't feel bad, like, you know, just rejoice, because You know that God shall avenge the blood of his innocent saints, the blood of the blameless and of his sheep. You know, for a time such as this is what was prophesied, foretold in the eternal scriptures. So this is happening right now, you know, to Christ Jesus and the whole body of Christ. Just as much as they persecute me, they're doing it to every Christian in the world through me vicariously. So it's the same thing, you know. So, I mean, let's say Jesus is Lord, man. Paradox or not paradox, I fear no evil, and I'm going to stand firm in my faith until I can't no more. That's that. Satan, go to hell in the name of Jesus.